I'm celebrating already. Why not? Why not? Welcome to the Pro Wrestling Potluck, the live weekly wrestling mixtape hosted by me, Scotland Green, right there. Great to be here in my own house, my apartment in beautiful parts unknown, Queens. Thanks for tuning in live. Thanks for tuning in on YouTube later if you're a YouTube person. We got a great one tonight. We got so much to do. We got a stacked, packed, and jacked show. We're going to be celebrating the Year of the Dragon. Andrew Heelan said, hey, why don't we celebrate the Year of the Dragon? I said, okay. I'm not going to do a whole gimmick episode about it because I just did a gimmick episode. More on that. But a flight of fancy. There'll be some dragons weaving their way in and out of this episode of the show. And yes, I did a special bonus episode on Tuesday night, a Mardi Gras special that is not on YouTube yet. I'm fighting with YouTube, and I just couldn't fuck with it. I had to mess with this. And over the weekend, I did a Buzz show, the Buzz Bowl. So, friends, pals, please remind me to never do that again. I'm never going to do three streams in a week again. It was great, but I have a whole thing where I got to promote the thing after I do it, and I can't promote it if I'm promoting the next one. So, it won't happen again. But they're both great. They're both great. If you were lucky enough to watch the Mardi Gras episode live in full, woo, it was fun. And the Buzz Bowl, so many great matches. And if you've never watched this before and you're watching live, I would strongly suggest you get in the chat. It's the best way to watch the Pro Wrestling Potluck. I'm laughing the whole time. If I didn't have to host this thing, I would just be in the chat cracking up, cracking wise, and learning a thing or two or 50 things and then forgetting them by the next week. Because that's what I do. Because I got Swiss cheese brain. All right. My producer, Sabrina, is telling me it's all good. Speaking of Sabrina, if at any point during tonight's broadcast you hear me yelling like there's an intruder in the apartment, it's me trying to get one of the cats away from the other cat's food. They both have special food that they gotta eat, and it's not the same special food. And if they eat each other's special food, they get special sick, and I gotta special clean it up. And I don't wanna do that. So on tonight's program, we will salute the Year of the Dragon. We will also dive back into our rad to sad catchphrases. This is where we were last week. We'll get back to this. I'll take some calls. Please call. Please call. It's voice only. I'm not gonna put you on screen and talk about your clothes or whatever. It's gonna be great. And we're also going to show my audition. I auditioned for WWE's The Bump. They recently let go their host, Matt Camp, and it said, "Oh, how about me? How about Scott Twist get in there?" And so we'll watch that later. And all right, that's it. Let's start the show. Let's start the GD show. Right. Here we go. I told you, Year of the Dragon. We're starting off with them dragons. Dragonly. Hulkster Jeff, how the heck are you, sir?
Y es así como aparece en esta México catedral.
I should make a tough enough audition tape. Are they still doing tough enough?
De Tala, Jalisco, el niño maravilla ante ustedes, Dragon Lee.
Look at that CMLL bug. Usually these things are right in the corner, and this one's inching its way. Why not just put it in the center of the screen? They'll bring it back if they see my tape. Yeah. Sobrevivió. Yeah, I'll audition. Maybe next week I'll audition for the Nitro Girls. Here he is, Bárbaro Cavernario.
Es un integrante de la peste negra. Y aquí llega con este ritmo y sabor, Bárbaro, Bárbaro Cavernario.
I think Bite Thus is gonna, I'm putting Bite Thus in our possible titles list. I know it was I know it was an error.
Luchane ha una sola caída y con límite de 10 minutos.
Bite Thus.
El integrante de la peste negra.
Now I once called Bite This and I talked to sex criminal Vince McMahon on an episode of Bite This. I said I mentioned TNA and talked about how they have a good they use cruisers and junior heavyweights the right way, and when are they going to do it? And he assured me they would. This was many, many years ago.
Qué confrontación, señoras y señores, la que vamos a vivir en este ring sagrado de la Arena México. Match relámpago, se van las bellas, se van las diosas.
That was me. I said something about like your competition. One thing they get right is their cruiserweights or something. I don't remember. That was me. And I can't find it.
Bárbaro Cavernario, salvaje más no poder. Y bueno, Dragon Lee, un triunfador en el Japón, en los Estados Unidos, en donde quiera que se presente, y por supuesto en territorio mexicano. ¡Qué duelo en este ring sagrado de la Arena México!
Aquí los tenemos, señoras y señores, amigos aficionados, los luchadores.
Hulkster Jeff, what did I think of the WrestleMania press conference? I thought it had ups and it had downs. The main event business was fun. I liked it. Everything else was a clown show, and it wasn't really a press conference. If you're not taking questions, it's just a little play that you put on. No, Bite This isn't on Peacock. They're about to not even have Thunder on Peacock.
Y esa rapidez, esa agilidad, esa habilidad, la tiene.
That's what we should do. We should gather all of our clips from the past and play them on an episode.
Bárbaro Cavernario viene con este movimiento, las tijeras de este joven maravilla.
Dragon Lee, oh my god, like a missile.
En ese tope suicida, espectacular.
I'm worried that once they make the move to Netflix, they won't have any of that stuff. It's like they only bought that stuff so no one else could have it, and they could control the way people think about wrestling and know things about wrestling. Once they got rid of their network, they don't give a shit about the past, my friends. Hulkster Jeff, you won tickets. Congratulations.
Rombo de batalla de 6x6 de la México Catedral. ¿Cómo va dando la vuelta al planeta?
ETL Blood Feast on an episode of Yo Mama.
Perfectamente las artes marciales.
I'm jealous.
Que estudió la lucha libre profesional y que es uno de los acróbatas más impresionantes del Consejo Mundial de Lucha Libre.
I had 24/7. I loved it.
Dragon Lee a la una, a los dos.
Ooh.
Pecho con pecho. Llegó pleno sobre su rival.
When the network first started and they were like actively trying to get wrestling fans and non-WWE fans to watch, it's the best period of that company.
Hemos vivido, señores, en prácticamente ya 3 minutos de este match relámpago. Ya lo sabíamos, no hace falta ser adivinos para decir la calidad de esta confrontación. Cuidado, porque ahora el turno. El dominio es para el Bárbaro Cavernario.
That's why bootlegging is key. Archive.org, Billy, all the rest, all my good friends. I wrote a Valentine, I gave a Valentine to Billy.
Impactante el desarrollo de esta batalla, como lo mencionabas, apenas
24/7 had the original Legends of Wrestling, which was just like all the old timers smoking cigars and talking shit. It was awesome. Espectaculares. Y ahora Bárbaro Cavernario intentando tomar el dominio de la batalla, esperando, Miguelito, que no sea un golpe prohibido este. Aquí viene poniendo las rodillas por delante. Dragon Lee held on. I don't know what happened with that one.
No se lo llevó al toque de espaldas. Prefiere más castigo aquí este Cavernario. Ahí lo tiene usted. Rudo. Al 100% y la patada tremenda.
I think every ECW episode is on archive. I know all the TNN episodes. Oh, he's doing the weird spit thing. God damn it. Come on, Cavernario. I like you, but I don't want to see you do the bully with the spit hanging, suck it back in. Nah. He's from a different time.
En la lona sabe que tiene que aniquilarlo, no permitirle ahí que recupere energías. Sin embargo, poder de recuperación increíble el de este joven luchador, juventud, divino tesoro. Ahí está. Dragon Lee, cuidado. Zona de tierra, se viene. Con estas tijeras lo está atrapando. El Bárbaro Cavernario, sin embargo, reacciona. Dragon Lee. El golpazo tremendo del Cavernario. Y ahora el que está en problemas es Dragon Lee, porque quedó en una situación comprometida.
Yeah, those people are heroes. Through the ropes. Oh my god. Cavernario.
Cerca del poste, el Bárbaro Cavernario, no midiendo el riesgo entre segunda y tercera. Aquí lo vamos a ver. Vea usted qué lance.
Look at that.
Peligrosísimo. Jugándose la vida. Así. De esta manera se lanza.
The King of the Stone Age.
Un pequeño rincón ahí. Se lanzó el hombre de las cavernas y va por más sobre Dragon Lee, que está sintiendo todo el rigor de ese salvaje de los cuadriláteros. Vaya, vaya castigo. Ahí en el barandal se va a lesobar. Y bueno, a pesar de que Dragon es un gran consentido de toda la fanaticada.
Right into the Boeing. Well, that's going right into my possible titles list. Right next to Bite Thus.
Ahí está el hombre de las cavernas dominando las acciones de una forma clara, contundente. Sobre un Dragon que tiene que reaccionar cueste lo que cueste. Tiger Casas.
De verdad que para Dragon Lee el panorama está súper oscuro y Bárbaro Cavernario lo sabe. Está aprovechando su fuerza física ante la estatura de Dragon Lee.
Real, reliable arbiter. Thanks for cheering. Empeño
es lo que lo hace levantar, señor.
Efectivamente.
Hopefully you had a good day at work.
Y aquí la condición física empieza a ser factor.
I don't know what product Boeing is. Mom, we're out of Boeing!
Dos. Alcanzó a contar el referee. La bestia negra tuvo que suspender porque...
Yeah, I'm glad you're here for the start. When I have all the energy and all the power and all the confidence. And then by the end of the show, I'm beaten down. Not really. Not really. I gained strength throughout the night.
Y tratando de sacar la cajita de Pandora, vean
ahora. I'm not googling that.
Al estilo del Muay Thai y la patada al estilo arte marcialista.
Stop that.
Parecía prohibido. Le dio toda la vuelta. Cayó de cabeza. Las cervicales seguramente.
I did not see Jeff Hardy being knocked out, but I heard about it, and it's unfortunate. It's like, don't those boys know they're on Rampage? You don't have to go that hard on Rampage, my friends. This isn't Collision. Necro Eric in the house. Cavernario's got Dragon Lee up. Dragon Lee finds a way out. Cavernario put down Dragon Lee. Lands on his feet. Back roll. Standing. Spanish fly. Dos. This is my theory. Sammy grew up on the Hardy Boys, and subconsciously he blames them for his current life. There is some part of Sammy's life that he's very unhappy with.
No se ve para dónde. muy cerca del final. Una caída, límite 10 minutos. En todo lo alto, así poniendo la rodilla por delante, castigando a Dragon Lee. Viene el bárbaro Cavernario, es hora de cuerdas para caer en plancha.
Oh, Necro Eric, you saw the Mardi Gras show, the salute to New Orleans. That's not on YouTube, but it does live on Twitch in full. I'll get it onto YouTube. I just have to edit one, at least one, maybe two matches. Once I take two matches off, then I start to be like, what's the point? But there was some good stuff on that show. Great laughs. Maybe I gotta put it up.
Ahora sí, 9 minutos, falta únicamente un minuto. Vamos a ver hacia dónde se inclina la balanza.
Cuenta regresiva y las acciones parejas. Cualquiera se puede llevar esta confrontación. Si llegan a los 10 minutos.
It's on my Twitch right now. The VOD of it is on my Twitch.
Dragon Lee, pero lo hace caer. El bárbaro Cavernario.
Two things got me. One, we all could have expected the Impact versus Lucha Underground, LAX versus Killshot and Willie Mack. Completely no way.
Thrace!
So that was a no-go. And then, the thing that made me the most angry, or I just gave up, is the Rob Van Dam versus Masato Tanaka match. They claimed 2 minutes in the middle of it. Just 2 minutes in the middle. And this is a match I got off of YouTube. It's not like I'm getting it off of Peacock. And it's already on YouTube in bootleg form. Normally I would just fight it immediately, but I'm already sitting on a copyright strike, so I'm a little gun-shy on my fighting the WWE. And I don't want to fight the WWE too hard. I'm trying to get hired to do the bump. Scotty Twist. Shed these glasses. Yeah, exactly. The match is already, it already had three less minutes than reported by Cage Match. But you know what? A couple days from now, I might not care at all. And I'll just put it up with 2 minutes missing. And the folks that watch it on YouTube, you know, you gotta watch the show live. This is a show for the live. The live audience.
Vamos a ir a esto, a la reconstrucción de los hechos. Ven ustedes con esta lanza, así clavando
pies sobre la variedad del bárbaro Cavernario.
Dragon Lee se encaminaba al triunfo. 3 segundos ahí en la lona del bárbaro.
You know, if I can't get WWE's the bump, I'd love to get a bump from Tony Khan. You heard me?
Consiguiendo la victoria en este cuadrilátero con historia y tradición de la Monumental Arena México. Vuelvan a vivir el final.
Me and Tom Green are bootleg battlers, baby.
Este fue el ganador, Dragon.
And you check him out on Tuesday nights, WCW Deep Cuts. I was fortunate to follow Deep Cuts. Oh, here we go. Doing it with soul, baby.
And you stroll down the streets of Chicago, streets of Milwaukee, streets of Boston. They gonna say the Crusher, Rhodes, the greatest team in the world, greater than Nixon and Agnew, greater than any major sporting event in the world, the Crusher. And you know why? Because it's the first time, baby. Listen to me now. It's the first time. It's been done with soul. You understand? It's been done before. It's been gouged and kicked. It's been done by great holes, by in great numbers. There is only one thing.
I believe Andrew Heelan sent this one in.
It's done with soul. All of it. Everything. Baby, you done stuff with soul before. You laid out there and took your little wife down the street to the zoo, and you did it with soul.
Yeah.
You strolled along with soul.
You took your little wife to the zoo.
Monkeys and giraffes with soul. You understand? Me and the Crusher are doing it with soul. That's all. I don't mind telling you. Bach, Wiggle, and Stevens, the rain is over. The rain is, that's the word. Look at that. Look at the man there, Jack. The rain is over. It's over. I was a little bully. I used to beat up people all the time. The Crusher was a bully. What's wrong with a bully when they got soul? Everybody loves a soul bully. I might make a song.
Soul bully.
You understand? It's great. It's here. Happy being here. Walking and strolling on the sidewalks of Chicago. Let me tell you what's going on now is a crusher and Rhodes. Write it in your book. Put it under your pillow because the fairy is going to bring you something for it. Mr. Soul, American Dream, 280 pounds of sweet-smelling soul jack. When everybody's in the back laughing and joking, Big Dustin out and Crusher's out front, woo, cooking and smoking.
Yes. Oh, my God. That was awesome. Now, Cool Dude Food, Owen Straw, sent this one in. This is the anime opening for Dragon Gate. Every wrestling company should have a fucking anime intro. This is incredible. Oh, that's incredible. Wow, that was awesome. Okay, hold on. Hold on. I gotta apologize for the opening of this. I don't want to see Russo and the gang. This match that's coming up, it was sent in by John Sartori. You check out John and Ann's wrestling podcast on YouTube.
Come on, Eric, do something here.
Vince Russo is the scum of the earth. Look at Mr. Perfect, he's dressed like Christian.
What a stark contrast in dressing rooms.
Hey! Thanks for the subscription, I appreciate it. And that triggers the FMW alarm, which, you know, gets in my brain. Got here just in time. This is your segment that you sent in. Sartori sent this one in. Coming out first. Mike Awesome, a potluck favorite.
He's gonna explode back there.
Holding his back, that's not a good sign. He's selling.
But Russo has been the hothead. He's been reacting impulsively all night. As you said, he's the one that called for it, and it's backfired in his face. What does that tell me? Could that mean that Russo is even more dangerous?
So about the halfway point of the show, I'll open up the phones, the Zoom phones, and we'll get back into our Rad to Sad catchphrases.
Back in the ring with the mic.
Did a couple more on there.
Well, well, well. What do you know? I drew Sting's name out of the boot tonight.
Whoa! Well, the term talk is cheap.
And hey, Stinger.
Talk is cheap.
Whether you're coming from the
now.
Front door, the back door, the side door, the rafters, wherever, why don't you just fly your Batman ass on down here?
You gotta get
so this is a Sting match. Sting's about to hang it up. So I'm trying to watch a Sting match a week on this show. And are we watching Sting's greatest hits? No. This is the Pro Wrestling Potluck. I'm not trying to watch everybody's greatest matches. We're watching selections from different time periods. Is this good? Is this bad? I don't know, but we'll have fun watching it together. Fly your Batman ass on down here. I've added it to the list. But I don't know if any possible title. I wrote down a possible title during that Dusty Rhodes promo. Soul Bully. I think Soul Bully, it's going to be hard to beat that. It's short. It's fire. That dirty ass canvas. What is this, GCW? Mike Awesome selling. Look how red with that red liquid that Sting poured over Vampiro. Ooh, that red liquid. The canvas spilled all over the canvas. It is like a battlefield in itself. This happened here. Sting has certainly made his fight the Soul Bully. Covering Vampiro from head to toe in that red liquid, and now he's taking it out of Mike Awesome. We have seen a newfound intensity in already intense individuals like Hogan, like Ric Flair, like Kevin Nash. I'll never figure out what that red liquid is. I guess it's a red drink. I don't do Dusty Rhodes impressions. I'm not an impressionist. Thank you. At some point, there was a time in my life that I could do a pretty good Bret Hart impression. Oh, this is it for Mike Awesome. This is a quick one. It's WCW. And he has a bad back. Yes, sir, we know it. Oh. And guess what? You better take They're playing back. The music already?
Don't have to, do you?
This is...
Millionaire's Cup, that's another one. He's tapping with the right hand. You saw the
What's
right
going
hand.
On? What is
He's
this? See, this is what I said. I don't know if it's going to be good, but we're going to have fun going through it together. Because I don't watch these things first. Oh, Lord, no. Okay. Now, this was sent in by the Suzanimal, Adam Suzanne, top contributor to the Potluck. Oh, my God. New York rules. There is a thunder where Russo declared that the wrestlers counted their own falls. Should I put on different music? Is this going to get me in trouble? Should I Frito twist it? So they got a ref for this. No ref for Thunder, but they have a referee for this. A wrestling version of Eyes Wide Shut? I'm there. This is awesome. What is this? La arena estaba de bote en bote, la gente loca de la emoción. En el ring luchaban los cuatro rudos, ídolos de la afición. Then they switch. Oh. If I was a cartoon and you hit me in the head with a hammer, this is what would be flying around my head. Who's your favorite? Everybody pick a favorite. They're all fakes. See, I have something for everybody. You know, some people like the New York Rules Thunder, and some people like this Lucha dance-off. There you go. Oh, I'm so glad. Oh, man, that's awesome. I'm glad you like it. And I'm a big fan of your art. People should follow you on Instagram. Oh, hold on one second. I must do a bumper. Hold on.
Future, everything will be simple. With just a look and a thought, anything can be yours. Looking further.
Oh, yeah, we have always been down.
Deeper. Longer. Into the buzz.
Alright. Here we go. Our buzz bin match. One of two buzz bin matches on tonight's show. Hot matches that people are talking about. This was sent in by ATL Blood Feast, my buzz supplier. This is the finals of the Max Hart Tag Team Tournament. Now let me get my little note out. You know what? I could have fast-forwarded some of this. Alright. So how about after this, we do calls, we get back to our Rad to Sad catchphrase list. I encourage you to call, even if you've called before, call again if you have a new one. Why not? Or if you want to argue about one of the ones that's already on there. All right, Arisu Endo. Suzume together, they are Daisy Monkey, my new favorite tag team name. And their opponents, Hakuchumu is the name of their team, and it's Miyu Watanabe and Rika Tatsumi. That's great news. He deserves it. So Miyu Watanabe, is she the person who did a giant swing on two people? I saw a gif of that. Maybe it's from this match. Maybe I'm spoiling something. If so, my mistake.
そして昨日に2024年のタッグ、このトーナメント節目くりにふさわしい2チームが上がってきたなと改めて思いますね。こう、手堅し。どちらも勢いは間違いなくあります。経験から言ったらもちろん白チームなんですけどもね。そうですね。過去に一度ベルトも巻いています。2019年なので、もう4年ぐらい。そうなんです。
Alright, Daisy Monkey in control in the beginning. Leapfrogs.
どっちが主導権を握るかっていうスタートですよね。すぐに奪い返そうとするデイジーモッキー。だがこれを待っていたハクチュー。
Oh, this is an awesome opening. Lots of reversals from both sides.
Oh, double no yokuri no emi no tame. Deiji Monkey count 2 です。
2.
待っていたハクチュー。 Double.
Oh,
かかれた。
Alright, Fanzine 97 giving some background. Daisy Monkey, the young up and comers. This is a big match for them. Paizan elbow. Two. Dos, dos, dos. Endo's getting her foot ripped off.
このチームすごいやっていそうで、実は純粋なタッグって1回しかやってないんですよね。ああ、そうですね。そうなんですよ。あの、スズメが、あの、タツミイカのベルト延長戦する前に全勝戦としたタッグしかなかったですね。6人とかそういうのではあるんですけれどもね。純粋なのはね。はい。その時もね、その全勝戦の方がクローズアップされちゃってましたね。そうでしたね。はい、やっぱり辰巳スズメの前哨戦という意味合いのタッグでしたので。
Nice drop kick by Endo. Yeah, you're right. Pair of back elbows. Tatsumi down.
あと一歩というところまではね、成長したんです。
It's caught her in a choke.
早くも首に。スズメの首を絞めています。ドラゴンです。すごい絵ですね、それはね。
It's an interesting time. I think people are going to be stepping up.
Yeah, that's. I mean,
New Japan has the best talent. But I feel like the past couple of years they were kind of stagnant. So this is a shakeup. It's unfortunate, but it's going to be good. Bending Suzume over her knee.
もうね、2頭どころか3頭ぐらい追っちゃう勢いですから、今の渡辺美優は。もうどんどん大きいウサギを追っていくって言ってましたから、まあシングルもそう、そして、タッグもそうということになりますよね。考えてみたら、渡辺美優がハクチュームで初めてベルト取った時、まだキャリア2年程度だったんで、ベルトの巻き方知らなかったんですよ。そうなんですよ。ね、辰巳リカに巻いてもらって、まあその人が今ね、もうそういうトップレスラーなわけですよね。
さあ、辰巳リカ選手がまた良からぬことを考えています。
ひどいことになりますね。
ここに3年の暴走ぶりはすごいですね。
Oh man, it's Hiromu time. Hiromu's popular. I think they should both move up.
最高の意味で辰巳リカは落ち着かないですよね。
いいですよ。落ち着いてほしくないですもん。
全然10年っぽくないですもん。
確かに。ミュー選手ってどちらかというと何かこう突拍子もない発言だったりが面白がって取られること。
Man, I haven't seen Noah in a little bit. We were watching a steady weekly dose of Noah on this program.
だから山下選手やね、中島選手、しみじみというようにね、辰巳リカ選手に対するですねコメントを言うてた。しみじみと。
そうですね。
Now, excuse my ignorance here. Is this this is a tournament, a tag team tournament? This is the finals of the Max Hart tournament. Are there belts involved? I don't know. Can someone clear it up for me?
両国でのシングルのベルトの調整が決まっている以上、ミュー選手はもう一つも落とさないとどこにも隙は見せられないんですよね。
そうですね。もう本当に今意識がね。感情が先走ってるんで渡辺美優。もう何だったら両国で全部やってるがいるぐらいの。
そうなんですよ。
そんな勢いですもんね。
はい。Endo back in。
タッグも一日で挑戦する
。Winner gets a title shot. Thank you。
と言ってますからね。
でもそんなね、
自分たちを飛
ばして先を見ているね渡辺美優を。何クソと思ってるのがデイジーモンキーでしょう。
いいですね、アリ選手充実してますね。
I love when companies go to kayfabe war. Back to the ropes. Miu's got a lot. Still in the tank.
でも自力じゃない初勝利は実はね6戦目なんですよ、うん、その時はタッグなんですがパートナーがスズメ紙服だったんですよ。
なるほど。
初めてのいわゆるシングルじゃない形式の試合で初めて勝った時にパートナーがスズメがいたというのがまたミソなんです
よ。その時からすでにということ、はい、
すごい、さすが登場一のパワーファイター。
お
ーこの筋肉に裏打ちされたパワーと圧力。
Yeah, that rules.
渡辺美優。
I had a Noah match or two set up for the Buzz Bowl on Sunday, but we didn't get there. I overbooked that one. And that was a 3.25 hour show.
キャリア6年目に、6年迎えましたからね。
そうなんですよね。
7年目に突入ですね。
7年といったらもう本当に十分なキャリアになりますよね、東京女子の。
Rika Tatsumi back in。
そしてパワーの後は辰巳選手がこうじわじわとね足を削ってきますね。
Her Suendo trying to tag out to her partner Suzume。
リカ選手は技の調子は非常にベーシックですからね。ベーシックなところと時々こうクレイジーな部分はありますけれど、ね、
本当な部分はどっちかというと昭和のプロレス的な技なんですよね。
それも面白いのが、半ば強制的にね、この辰巳リカドラゴンという異名をですね、背負わされてですね、
はい、
そうせざるを得なかったというのがね、最初の辰巳リカで、はい、まだ何者形が出来上がってなかった頃の辰巳リカからここまで持ってきましたからね。
そうなんですよね。
お、今ちょっと感じてますよ。このあたりがうまいですよね。
おおおおおはい、
ダメ
飛ばしてのヒップアタック。
リカ選手も決して小型ではないですからね。それをミサイルのように投げましたからね、ミュウさん。
軽々。
軽々。
振り越しのバックブリーカー。レイジンモンキーが圧倒されています。
ひょっとしてこの体勢は まとめちゃいますか？まとめちゃいますか？そんな
力が有り余っている。
Yeah, she's like deceptively strong. I mean, does it look good? Oh my god, look at this! Here we go! Double giant swing! Yeah, she's jacked! Wow, yeah! Oh man, that ruled.
でも、
そう、 でその後のミュー選手が全くブレてないのがすごいんですよね、
は
い、
きっとこの光景は海外のファンも熱狂してるでしょう、
なんか
That's so awesome
ああいうのあるよねみたいな感じの、はい、形状でした
さあ進みにかかるドギボを抜かれるような荒技を見せた渡辺美優おお。
Endo fighting back, but it might have been all she had.
そうなんですよね。でもあのそもそもフリーワイファイが返上したベルトを1月4日にこのハクチューブとデジモンと雪にきで争って雪
にきで争ったベルト
という意味ではこの1月にフィラションをしたばっかりなんですよね。
Hakuchumu means daydream. Not as great as Daisy Monkey. Miu crawling while in the camel clutch. Oh! Look at this! This is dope. Fighting for a tag shot. Endo on the back. I don't know if that's where she wants to be. Rika tags herself in. Yeah, Lucha companies don't care about stuff like that. They don't care about a lot of things. I mean, they book Alberto Del Rio still.
パワー持ってますからね。
さあ、スズメだ。
スズメ。
ここで一気にリング上を引っ掛けますか。
引っ掛けましたいですね。動きたいですね、スズメ選手。
一度羽を羽ばたかせたら。
Now she's got great look. Cool boots, big sleeves. Cool boots, big sleeves. Can't lose.
で勝ってますからね。プリンセスカップでね。
Yeah, Triple A books Alberto, Marty Scurll. They're about to book Vince McMahon. They'll give Vince McMahon a run. Takes out some guests that are hanging around nearby.
デジモンにそれがあるかですよ
ね。I've never seen hackers, but now I should. Inching over. Rika Tatsumi. Toes away, a toe length away. After this, I'm opening up the Zoom. We're gonna be talking catchphrases, filling in some more of these blanks. We're not gonna fill it up because I want to put it back on Instagram, let people get mad at it, and then we'll finish it off next week. But we'll get a few more up there.
とも、また新しい魅力ですからね。おお、
これはいい。There's all the way around. Look at this.
タツミリカを翻弄していく。心重ねてドロップキック。おお、エンドアリスが、エンドアリスが、スズメを引っ張っていく。
Oh my god, look at this, the strength! Wow. Scoop slams them both. Ooh. Yeah, hit them all, make a pile. Two. Dragon backbreaker. I would love to dye the sides of my head to match a very specific shirt that I wear. He's got, is it Bulk or Skull who has that hair? Put on the ropes. Bulk. I used to love the music that was in the background whenever they would have the Bulk and Skull segments on Power Rangers. It would be like, meow, 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 meow. That's the Bulk and Skull theme.
Ooh.
I wonder. I mean, you know, obviously I'm someone who does that, who thinks of a show and is like, there's got to be wrestling. There's got to be wrestling in the Alvin and the Chipmunk show, right? And stuff like that. I don't know. I know there's Power Rangers in wrestling, of course. Great teamwork. Whoa, turning her around. Rika got confused. I once, this is a sad admission, but I once wrote a letter to the Pink Ranger, Amy Jo Johnson, inviting her to my birthday party. And I was too old to do that. I was not a little kid. I was not a man, but I was in between. Old enough to be in love with Amy Jo Johnson and too old to innocently invite her to my birthday party. Yes, last year. Ooh, hip attack. The rear view, she calls it the rear view. I never watched Buffy the Vampire Slayer. Everyone else in my life has and had. I've seen random stuff. I thought it was fine. I love teen drama, so if I started watching it, I would probably get way into it.
もうないかもと思った先のこの絞り出せる力です。あ、でも足掴んでますよ。
There is a Lucha episode of Angel. Have we used something from that before? Have I seen that? Maybe not. Whoa, I gotta find that. Somebody send that to me. Ooh. Got hops. Oh, that froze in midair. Daisy Monkey. Arisu, Endo, and Suzume. They did it! Yatsa! You can't lose when you got sleeves like that. Great match. Thanks for sending that in. ATL Blood Feast. I'm always taking submissions. You can hit up my Instagram or email prowrestlingpotluck@gmail.com. Good stuff, weird stuff, bad stuff. I save it all. All right, I'll be right back. I'm going to put up a be right back screen with the QR code. Let's add to our Rad to Sad catchphrases list. Audio only, no need to brush your hair or put on a shirt. All right, now. This is where we were last week on the show. We don't have all the rads. Ooh, pardon me. We don't have all the sads. Our top rad is number 3 with Huss. Number 4, Bret Hart's Best There Is, Best There Was, Best There Ever Will Be, a classic. 5, Taz, Beat Me If You Can, Survive If I Let You. 6, I'm Here to Kick Ass and Chew Bubblegum, and I'm all out of bubblegum. 8, we got Mr. About. 2 words, nunchucks. We heard that last week and immediately went in here. And it's a potluck list. 9, Sartori made a great case last week for what? Something that we all hate. But when Steve Austin actually did it, it was pretty great. And mid, we got Slap Nuts taking up the mid spot. And then sad, we don't have a lot of sads. We have What's Up, which Dr. Liam called and gave us that. Woo from Charlotte and from John and Ann's Wrestling Podcast gave us that. And 3, Boots to Asses. Nathan, you're saying that Slap Nuts is good. Where would it go? It would move up one spot if it was good. Lack of sads is surprising. The one that I got on Instagram that I forgot to add, or at least, Slap Nuts is good. All right, well, I'll switch him then. All right. Slap Nuts is on the good side of mid, but I'll put it at number 9, and I'll put what? I'll just do a little surgery here. Okay, everybody wants Slap Nuts. I'm fixing it. I'm fixing it right now. Where is this thing? Oh, here it is. All right. Here we go. So Slapnuts, no longer mid. It's moving up. All right, wow, our rad list is almost there. That's very scary. And the sad list is nowhere. You know, we still got some more sad. You know what, there's a forgotten double J catchphrase that I forgot to talk about last week that he briefly had. And then it went away. It used to start his song. He would say, "There's all the other superstars, then there's me." And I kind of want to add that. But I need someone else to tell me that that's what it was, because that's how I remember it. His song. This was when he came back and he was wearing like the Navajo print getup. It was the NWA NWA Jeff Jarrett version in WWF. And his entrance music, I swear it said, "There's all the other superstars, then there's me." I think I'm putting that on the list. I have no callers. This is in the toilet. Okay, good. Well, then someone has confirmed it. I'm putting it on the sad list because it is so sad. I'm putting it here. Oh, really? You can't get through? What is the deal? Maybe it's my fault. Maybe it's the wrong. Let's see. Does it connect you to this Zoom or? Oh, it says I have another meeting in progress. Oh, God. Hold on. Oh, God. Okay. Let's see if this works. I think it still had last week's that used to work, but since I stopped paying for Zoom, it doesn't work. I have to set up a new one every week. So let's see if this works. If you're in the Zoom room, it might be the wrong room. This might be the right one. Let's see. If this doesn't work, I'm just going to, we'll just do it next week. Oh no, people are there. All right, we're gonna do it. We're doing it. First up, yep. All right, connecting to audio, we got Tom Green.
Hey, can you hear me?
I can hear you. Yes, we're
great.
Doing it.
Welcome. Hello to my K-fabulous cousin, Scott.
Ooh,
Green.
I love that Hello. Word, K-fabulous. Yes. Hell yeah.
Yes.
Not that Tom Green. Tuesday nights, WCW Deep Cuts.
Indeed, and I'm also streaming Sunday at 8 on both Twitch and YouTube.
Double
off
dose.
Off the grid. Yep, it's stuff that won't get me kicked off YouTube. So real obscure stuff.
Hmm.
So that'll be fun. I have a sad catchphrase.
That's what we need.
Okay. So it's a long one. We might be able to shrink it down a little bit, but
okay.
If you're not, let's get ready to suck it. And if you're not down with that, I have two words for you. Which are also suck it.
I think Let's Get Ready to Suck It is definitely going in there. Yes.
Like I don't like the idea that you get a choice and then Triple H takes it back.
Yeah, I'm actually gonna put them both for now, but one, yeah, I'm not putting them in order just to get them. If you're not down with that, ... All right, and then this other one, ... All right, so you just got two on the board. Let's get ready to suck it. And if you're not down with that, we got two words for you: suck it.
Yeah. I'm surprised Buffer never tried to sue. Because he suits for everything.
Yeah.
Like, if you say the word rumble in a certain cadence, even if you don't say it with the rest of it, he will sue you. So.
I love that his brother also is a ring announcer and also has a goofy catchphrase.
And was his agent.
Oh, really?
Recently also. Yeah. Like, if you wanted to book Michael, you had to go through Bruce, who was also trying to get his own ring announcing career off the ground, which he did, and now he does like a goofy twirl in an octagon. Like, what have you ever heard of the Buffer 360?
No, I actually haven't. I just know that he goes, okay. It's time.
Yeah, so in title fights sometimes he'll do a 360 degree jump, like a twist in the air, and then points, and they call it the Buffer 360. It's so dumb. I love it.
Wow. Yeah. I got to study. Yeah. I got to study under the feet of the master. As a ring announcer, I got to see what these other ring announcers are doing.
Now you have to do like a flip. You have to like go to the top.
Do a kip up.
Yeah. Start doing Lucha with whoever's in the ring, the referee. Do like a whole Lucha sequence.
Here's a little peek behind the curtain. Every time I'm ring announcing, I look at the referee and I say, "You're not gonna let them hurt me, are you?" I do it every time.
Good.
Every referee has heard that from me.
I love it because then the audience is like, "Ooh, that's a tough guy."
Yeah.
Not you, the wrestler. No offense.
Yeah. The audience has no respect for me.
No, I mean they're calling you like minion characters.
Yeah. And speaking of that, I'll be in Haverstraw on Saturday. So the child who called me now I'm forgetting Vector, the kid who called me Vector, will no doubt be there. He is the only child in the enemy of the show pile.
I mean, there could be more someday.
Oh, yeah.
Who knows?
Oh, yeah. Well, Tom, do you have any other ones?
No, I just... Let's Get Ready to Suck It has always bugged me. Because, again, you have consent at first. There you have the illusion of consent. And then Triple H takes it away. And it's like, buddy, what are we doing here?
That's some WWE stuff.
Exactly. Corporate officer number one.
Yes.
But thank you so much for taking my call.
No problem. Thanks for calling. I'm sorry about all the shenanigans leading up to it.
Hey, good news. I got an apology from the guy.
Oh.
Yeah, a friend of mine might have bullied him.
Beautiful.
Yes, so it is thankfully all clear. So
good. That's good news.
Yeah. Yes. So, but thank you for listening to me complain earlier privately.
Always.
And thank you to all the Potluckians. That's a phrase I just came up with.
I like it.
All the pals for being here every Thursday. I appreciate it.
Yes, so do I. All right, Tom, I'm going to let you go, and I'm bringing on Nathan. Good night, Tom. Nathan in the house.
Can you hear me?
I can hear you.
Oh, lovely. I got one that's rad, but it's also deserves to be in sad.
Okay.
Taking it back to 2001, DDP has just been buried by The Undertaker and his wife. And then the motivational speaker, which had the pretty good line of, "I like me, you like me, and I'm going to help you like you."
Oh, but yeah. I forgot about that.
It belongs in sad. It was kind of rad, but it belongs in sad because that whole it, him doing that meant that they kind of dropped the ball with the whole fact that DDP was like the people's champ of WCW. So like,
yes,
the character was a demotion. It was a good line, but the fact that he had to say the line is kind of sad because they dropped the ball with DDP.
You know, that might, you made a case that might be mid. That might be the mid.
It would be a good mid one too.
Yeah, I think I'm gonna put it in the mid. I'm gonna trend it towards rad. I like me. You like me. Let me help you like you.
That's it. And I'm gonna help you like you.
And I'm going to help you like you. Okay. That's on the board.
It's a very good one.
Now, yes.
I have a suggestion. We were just mentioned that in the chat, but like, let's get ready to rumble. It has, it's belongs at number one so much that the person that created it will sue you if you decide to emulate it, right?
Yeah, I don't know. I mean, yeah, I guess it is a catchphrase. Yeah. But I don't know. Let's get ready to rumble. Everyone knows it. Maybe I'll put it at number two for now, but it might get bumped.
Number two is a very solid spot too. Number two is above Huss, and Huss is very good.
Yeah, maybe. Well, I might have to do a little surgery and move some things around once I'm. But let's see. Let's get ready to rumble. Too basic, says the chat, or is they talking about something else? Too basic.
I do have one from the heart, if you don't want to go, let's get ready to rumble.
What's that?
So, oh yeah, and I'm not talking about Randy Savage's oh yeah. I'm talking about the manager of The Undertaker, Paul Bearer, with every promo starting with,
ooh. Oh, yes. Oh yeah, that's oh yes.
Oh yes. To oh yes.
Okay. I'm gonna move Huss up to two and oh yes.
Did I suggest it just so I can try that Paul Bearer impression? Maybe.
Well, you nailed it.
Oh, thank you. I've been practicing all of that. No.
Necro Eric is suggesting youth, which was suggested last week and got shot down. It is in the maybe pile for when we move some things around.
I'm almost considered Iron Sheik's bleep your bleep and make your make you humble.
Yeah, it's not going to make a potluck list.
I ran it through some focus groups and they were like, it can't.
Yeah. Nope, not this time. Well, we got two votes for youth. I'm writing it down. It's gonna go on the maybe pile because I'm gonna move these things around. I'm gonna have Instagram people vote on some stuff. But yeah, we're doing good. Nathan, you have any other ones?
I remember you posted a story of someone suggesting a pre-Ryback Skip Sheffield. Yep.
Oh God, thanks for reminding me. Yes, Brett Davis suggested yep, what it do. And I said I would put that on the list because I love it. Now, what do other people think of that? Because I thought it was great. yep, what it do.
Was there a what it do afterwards?
Yeah.
Oh, that makes it even more special.
The corn-fed meathead. You know what? I'm going to put it... there's nothing in the that it's going to squeeze out of rad. I'm going to put it... It's going to go mid. It's going to be the other mid for now. Yep, what it do. I think it's yep, what it do. All right.
I think you're supposed to say it so fast that no one can figure out which vowel you're using.
Yeah, it's a very country thing. All right, well, thank you so much.
I feel like we've made some great progress here today.
We really do, and I got some more calls to take, so I'm gonna let you go, and I might be squeezing some of these out. We'll see.
Oh, there's gonna be some great suggestions after me too, I bet.
Yeah. All right, well, thank you, Nathan.
Party, take care.
You too. And now entering the room, Andrew Heelan.
Andrew.
Oh, I heard myself. It's a good
Hello.
Sign. Yo.
All right. I'm ready to jump right into this. Oh. I got multiples, but I got a couple I kind of narrowed it down to. A couple of good rads, a couple of good sads. Tried to go a little off the grid. So where Perfect. Do you want to start?
Give me one sad to start.
Okay. For my sad. Big Boss Man, you will serve hard time.
All right, I'm gonna write that one down. I'm gonna write some down and then put them in.
Yeah, that's fine. Look, you're doing it a lot. We don't need you typing, also, man.
Yes, you will serve hard time. All right, and that is a sad one. Oh, and so sad. What else?
Okay, I'm going to jump over now. I'm going to give you a rad.
Mm-hmm.
Now, this was Steve Austin's first good catchphrase. When he was with the Hollywood Blondes, they would end their interview segments with, "Your brush with greatness is over."
Whoa.
And I just always really liked that one.
Yeah, I do. I like that.
Nobody remembers it except me, but it's really good.
Your brush with greatness is over. Brad. All right. And you have one more of each?
Yeah. I mean, I got a lot more, but I'm just not trying to monopolize the whole show here. Okay. This, honestly, I think will be a strong contender for the saddest. I tell you what, I'm going to hold off for that. I want to do my other rad because it's also a little off the beaten path. Gimmick, it didn't last long, but I think we all loved it and had high hopes. Sean O'Hare with "I'm not telling you anything you don't already know." Just such potential. It's hard to put it on the rad because it really never went anywhere.
Yeah.
But it's just solid. I want to throw that one out there. Okay. Now, this is going to be a strong contender for number one on sad. I feel it in my bones. You're either Nexus or you're against us.
Here we go. Yes.
Oh, that's sad. That makes nobody happy to hear that. No one's happy hearing that. It makes everyone feel worse.
All right. I don't think it's the worst, but I am going to do a reshuffling. I think I'm putting that at number two, and I'm going to put I'm a executive decision. I'm putting Boots to Asses at number one.
Fair. Look, we could have a whole list of just sad rock catchphrases.
Yeah, I know.
My gosh, there's dozens of those. And all the ones that he tried to get and they failed. There's so many failed rock catchphrases that he did like three or four times and then just quit. And they're all so, so bad.
Yes. All right, so I'm doing that. I'm putting Boots to Asses at number one. And you know what? I might get rid of my "There's all the other superstars, then there's me." Actually, you know what? I'm moving it back to number three. And the new number two. The new number two, what is this? The Prisoner? is you're either next us or against us.
Yeah.
There you go.
I'm sorry to make everybody sad by bringing up that Nexus catchphrase, but it's called Rad or Sad for a reason. It's not called Rad and also You'll Feel Good.
All right.
Good times as always, Scotland.
Yes, thank you so much.
All right. Keep it rolling.
I will. Thank you. You're either Nexus or you're against us. All right, that was Andrew Heelan. Next up, we got the Suzanimal, Adam Suzanne. I have people on hold that couldn't hold any longer. I'm so sorry.
Hello.
Adam Suzanne, what's up?
Not much. How are you, Mr. Green Mist?
I'm great.
So, in order to keep with the motif, submitted without judgment.
Feed me more. Feed me more. Feed
oh me man.
More.
See, I kind of liked Feed Me More.
It was fun. There was a playfulness to it.
Yeah.
That was missing from a lot of wrestling of that era. It was fun for a time.
Yeah. And I was a Ryback fan at that time. And I thought there was something happening with Ryback. I was like, man, he could be somebody. This is what I thought. I thought John Cena was their Hulk Hogan and CM Punk was their Roddy Piper, and Ryback could have been their Ultimate Warrior. Right? If you wanted to compare everything to the 80s, they had that. They could have had a great...
So Ryback would tank the business and then they would have to go back to Cena.
Yes. Yeah, that's probably what would happen. When I went to a Raw in New Orleans, the most popular person was Ryback. It was crazy.
He was in 2012, for that summer until that Hell in a Cell match with Punk. There was something brewing.
Yeah.
I think that was right around when Sandy hit, so I just wasn't able, I could have had to like scrounge to find a way to like get TV.
Oh yeah.
For like a week or two. Yeah. But I remember that. Yeah, no. That was I think, speaking of his WrestleMania 29 opponent, Mark Henry, I think he only said this once, but it's so good. That's what I do.
Oh yeah, that's what I do.
I don't know, you know, Mark Henry is a treasure. Man, he's a treasure, and
that's what I
do. I don't
know
how often he used that one, but it was just he knew it was perfectly timed whenever he did it.
Yeah, well, I added it to my maybe list because we only have one rad spot, so we're gonna be moving some shit around. Some stuff's gonna get bumped. Suzanne, well, do you have any more?
Just everything Taz says. With the Jones.
Yeah, Blank Jones.
Jambag Jones. Meme Jones.
Oh, man.
Buckshot
Blank
Jones.
Jones is pretty good.
Tie-Dye Jones, he has said.
All right, I'm writing these down, but not putting it on the list yet. But
Taz,
Blank Jones.
Taz going from scariest man to just kind of like dorky fun dad is really one of the most fascinating transformations in professional wrestling.
And he's good at it all.
A man can do everything.
Yeah.
A Renaissance man. Renaissance Jones. Michelangelo Jones. But I digress.
Yes. Digression Jones. All right, Suzanne, do you have any other ones?
I think anything that gets my new theory is anything that would be the best one would people would get sick of. It's the very nature of wrestling is anything that's good is worn out beyond enjoyment.
Yes, it's hard. It's hard for things to stay good.
Diminishing returns. So
yes,
and
I'm gonna add this for callers from now on. If there's something you think should be taken off the list, or if you have a suggestion for a replacement, let me know. I can be easily swayed.
I don't want to shake the sanctity of the list.
Yeah.
I'll step out.
All right. Well, thank you for calling and these great suggestions.
Thank you.
All right. Good night.
Good night.
Now joining... Dr. Liam Crimson Mask Replica on Instagram.
Hello, Scotland.
Good evening.
Good evening. How are you?
I'm great. I'm glad this is actually working out. I thought no one was calling. I was stalling, and I didn't know I had a link to the other Zoom.
Are you rad or sad this evening?
I am mid.
Excuse me. So I have two of them.
Oh.
I'll start with the two rad or sad. So okay. I have one rad, one sad.
Okay.
I'll start with the sad, and it's a pretty sad one. It's No Chance in Hell by Vince McMahon.
Oof.
Yeah.
Yeah.
I think it's one, like, if you ever get those Craigslist weirdos that you want, and they see it on sad, they'll get all offended.
I didn't continue my push of trying to get Craigslist people this week, but I need to. I think I'm going to leave Vince off the list.
Okay, I understand that. And for my rad one, I have to go with Dusty Rhodes. If you will. It's the American dream, if you will.
Yes. Now, how would we spell? Would it be W-I-L-L-L-L-L or W-I-I-I-I-L-L-L-L?
I would almost spell it like wheel, as in the object wheel. W-H-E-E-L.
If you will.
If you will, Scotland, if you will.
Well, that's a good Dusty. It's a good Dusty.
Thank you, baby.
There's the Dusty that people were looking for earlier. They didn't get from me. I can do Bret Hart. That's it. It's good
we
to be back in
Bret
Canada
Hart.
Where I'm still considered a hero. That's it. That's my impression.
That's a good one. That's a good one.
I used to really have it. I'm losing it.
There aren't too many Bret Hart impersonators out there.
No. Nope, not even Jason Sensation can touch that one.
We need Macho Verse in here.
Yeah, where is he?
I actually saw he's in Chile.
Oh, wow.
Yeah, we need him up in here complaining, where's all the Macho Man catchphrases?
Yeah, somebody did send me Macho Man's Oh Yeah, and I have it in the maybe list, but...
It's
and I might even add a couple... numbers to both of these because we're really getting good good ones. So I might recalibrate this list. That's why I'm writing all these down that I'm not putting on to this visual list.
Maybe the ones that are in the maybe list, maybe you have the IG people vote.
Yeah, that was my plan. And I meant to do it this week, but I just have been busy.
Yeah.
Any other ones, Dr. Liam?
No, it's been the potluck extravaganza, and I just want to thank you for the potluck palooza this week.
Oh, no problem. Thanks for watching.
Thank you for that.
All right. Well, I'm going to let you go. I got John Sartori coming in. John and Ann's Wrestling Podcast. And then I have two more people after him.
Oh, wow.
Yeah, we got a big list.
Thank you, Scotty.
All right, Dr. Liam.
Later.
Sartori?
Hey, Scotland, how's it going? It's Bret Hart here.
it's Bret,
show.
My mom's favorite wrestler.
Yeah, say hi for me. just hanging out here with my cat. I'm gonna get right into it here.
Yeah.
I thought of a sad one that I had completely forgotten about and then was reminded of when rewatching WrestleMania 15 and a bunch of weird, like, Attitude Era Raws and stuff. Sable's catchphrase of, for all the women who want to be me.
Oh, my God.
And the men who come to see me. It was so awful to watch for a number of reasons. Number one, obviously, it feels very degrading.
Yeah.
And, like, forced upon her. And then number two, the delivery was just so bad as well. So it was just a very, very sad catchphrase to see.
That's a bad one.
It was out of my head and now it haunts me.
Well, I think I'm going to add that one right now.
Okay, great.
It's a bad one.
It is a bad one.
Yeah.
Nothing mid about it.
Yeah, it's going to be at number 8 for now. And then who knows? I got to recalibrate this damn list. All right. Do you have any other ones?
The only other one I have swimming around in my head, and I actually don't know how I feel about it. It's probably sad, but it was Snitsky's It Wasn't My Fault.
Yeah.
And it's just so silly because it's I know what it's referencing, the context of it, but out of context, it's just him saying a normal sentence, and it's just so odd.
Yeah. Dr. Liam says sad. I'm writing it down. That's what I'm going to put up to vote.
Yeah, I don't know. It might not be anything, but it was just something that was in there. Oh, actually, I just thought of one. I don't know. Maybe somebody has seen it. Maybe somebody's put it in the chat or something. But did we talk about Lance Storms, if I could be serious for a second? Did anybody pitch that? I feel like somebody did.
No. I like that one.
Yeah. If I could be serious for a moment or whatever.
Yes.
A second, whatever he said.
I think it's moment.
I think it's a moment, yeah. That was great, because he was great. Very underrated in many ways.
All right, well, I wrote that one down in the maybe pile. I think what I am going to do is add 2 numbers to each one and then put it up to a vote.
Okay, that's great.
Yeah, okay. Any great, other
Scotland,
ones?
You know, no, that's pretty much it. It was good talking to you there, you know. I'm going to, you know, go now.
All right. Thank you, Brett.
All right. All right. Good to see you. Bye.
Good night. Next up, the Masked Teal, the other Scott. Good evening to the Masked Teal. Can you hear me? Connecting the audio. Connecting the audio. And then we have one more after him.
Okay.
Masked Teal.
Figure this thing out.
You got it. How you doing?
All right. Awesome. I'm doing super fantastic. So I got here's I'm going to nitpick a little bit.
Oh, please.
On the list. So when I think of sad, I think of stuff that didn't get over, like The Rock's popcorn fart towards Jonathan Coachman. That should be sad. But something like What's Up, that's rad because I actually got over. People, you know, were going batshit over.
Yeah, but it's bad things get over. That's what I'll say. What's Up got over, but it was 2 years after the Budweiser commercial. It was a little whack. It was sad
that
happened.
They got a good run out of that.
That's true.
It had some mileage. So I think even though it was the stuff that I got into, the fans did. So, you know, to me, you know, maybe not so sad, maybe more mid, but that's just me. That's me being nitpicky.
I hear you.
So I have a couple. The first one, Attitude Era Great, and it was the guaranteed panty dropper when I, right after high school, got into college for the first time. Hello, ladies.
Oh, man. All right. I put that on the maybe list.
Say that. The girls just be lining up to the big Balboski.
Yeah. All right. And I wrote that one down.
And then another, like, rarity, because unfortunately this didn't last long because he had to retire due to injury. Waylon Mercy's lives are gonna be in Waylon Mercy's hands.
Ooh, lives are gonna be in Waylon Mercy's hands?
Yes.
Ooh, I'm writing that one down. What was his other one?
Oh, he didn't really have, like, that was the beginning of his theme song. When he said that during his vignettes. So when I think of Waylon Mercy, that's usually what I think of. I don't think he really had anything else.
Oh,
really...
Suzanimal just said it in the chat. It was, you know what I mean.
Oh, you know what I mean? Okay, yeah.
All right. Well, okay, I got both of those written down. We'll put them up for the voting. Do you have any other ones?
Not now.
All right. Where are you calling from?
Indiana.
Oh, awesome. Cool.
just like Mr. Tom Green.
Yes. Well, thank you for calling. Appreciate it. Good night. Next up, Elliot in the house, ATL Blood Feast, my buzz plug. Damn, we got Buku, Indiana people in the house. Connecting the audio.
You hear me?
Yep.
Hey, what's up, buddy?
What's happening?
So I was thinking about like promos that I'll like watch over and over and over. And there's one that like I just kept coming back to, and it's from the Royal Rumble a few years ago when the Iconics got eliminated and Billy Kay and Peyton Royce are getting interviewed by Kathy Kelly in the background. And she said it all, a lot, but when Billy Kay says, "You've got to be joking me," that shit is so funny. And then she does the old, like, "Did you get a journalism for that?" That was pretty amazing, but I think that "you got to be joking me."
You got to be joking me. All right, I got that down in the maybe voting pile.
Yeah, it cracks me up all the time, and I always go back to watching that. But anyway, yeah, someone just said in the chat that they miss Peyton and Billy. And
oh, yeah, don't we all?
Always, they were always a highlight in the stinkiness of WWE, but that's all that I had. I just wanted to throw that one in. I know.
Well, great. Thank you so much.
To get back to the matches, but
yeah, I'm gonna have to figure out which stuff to cut, because this I went long with my my hemming and hawing before I knew I actually had callers. But thank you so much for calling, Elliot.
Yeah, absolutely. Thanks for playing all the great buzz and keeping smiles on all our faces. So have a good night.
Oh, my pleasure. All right. Good night. All right. That was it. That was such a crazy list. All right. Now I got to figure out what to remove from the show. I'm going to keep our main event and I think one other match. So we're going over our time, but we're not going to be crazy with it. Yeah, so I'll be right back in 1 second.
He just couldn't help himself. He's got to keep control, get down, make that ref turn around. Steamboat hit Vader, what, 6, 7, 8 times with a chair. No call for that. And Vader gets back to show you what kind of man he is. Most people cannot even get back to their feet after being attacked like that with a chair.
Timmy, I'm from the Dream.
You know what? I bumped two matches. We're only going to have the main event. We're going to watch a couple things of shenanigans. I'm going to show my my bump audition. And then we'll watch the main event.
Looks so real.
Don't count on Sprite.
...view with Al Jerusha, and watch what happens.
Suzanne will set this one in. Master Blaster showing up in the AWA.
Have you completely lost? What are you doing here? What are you doing here? Just tell me what you. No, wait a minute. Wait a minute. Whoa, whoa. No, 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 no.
Now, this is the Year of the Dragon, so I couldn't cut this. Dude, this song kind of rules. This sounds like some Genesis music. This has no right being this rad.
Hey,
boss music. Boss music's like Monday, and then it's the it's.
It's Christopher Honey Love being assisted by the Scorpions. What in the world is this, Michael, that they're bringing out here? This big, huge crate on rollers that they're bringing out here.
Oh, Sartori, that's my favorite shit. It's on YouTube. The 80s Alice in Wonderland TV special. It's got the greatest guest stars ever.
What I'm going to give the people is
Telly Savalas
in professional wrestling, honey.
Honey.
No, you people mind your own business and shut up while I'm out here. You can talk while everyone else out here. You will shut up while I'm out here. And I mean it, or I'll kick you all out of here. Now, there's a punk running around the world named Jerry Lawler.
It's got Carol Channing as the White Queen.
I have never told a lie in my life, honey. And I'm not going to start now. Jerry Lawler, you are a painful disgrace.
Oh, yeah, they got that scary Jabberwocky.
Because you are not a box office draw, the AWA world class, and who knows how many other promotions are out of business. Well, honey, I am the savior of the USWA. I'm going to make sure. You know, Eddie Marlin is a dear, dear friend of mine.
I love this honey
and
talk.
I have offered my services to Mr. Marlin to be a consultant. And the first thing that I've told him is we must get rid of Jerry Lawler. So, Jerry Lawler, what I'm doing, I'm giving you a two-week notice today. You have 2 weeks left of employment with the USWA, and I'm personally firing you. Because the box office receipts are going down all over the USWA. I'm here. They're going to go up, and I'm sure not going to let that punk take the credit.
Well, you're here, but I don't think you have the authority to fire Jerry
Lawler. Oh, yes, I do. Ask Eddie Marlin. I do. And Jerry Lawler, you just got your two-week notice, honey. Now let's go to the box, if you will.
All right. What's in the box here?
The people love me so much.
We should have been taking a drink for every honey.
Jerry Lawler, if you decide that you don't want to quit, this is what's going to take you out of the territory, honey.
Honey. Oh, shit.
Dragon Master.
This is the Dragon Master, honey. Come on out.
One more honey.
No, he's going to come out. Step on out of here. And you know why I'm going to have him step out? Take your time. This is my television show now, honey.
We should have bet on how many honeys were coming.
The reason I want him out here, come on over here, Dragon Master. The reason I want
he's
him
got to hold
here,
his hand and walk him around like he's Chuck E. Cheese.
Organizations around the world say we have a 7-foot giant, we have a 8-foot giant, and you get to the arena and he's 5'10". Well, honey, this man is 7'3", and Jerry Lawler, this is a man you can't beat. Take off the mask. Now people are saying, why do you got that goofy hood on him? Let me tell you something, honey. Look at this, Jerry Lawler. You're going to dream this. This is your worst nightmare, honey. This man is legitimately 7'3". And you know what, Jerry Lawler? You're going around the world saying, who is he? Honey, you know who he is. He's an international star, honey. But no way am I going to let you study him. If you find out who he was, obviously he'd know his weaknesses. Every man has them except me, honey. No, honey, I'm going to keep the mask on this giant. This is a giant. Davey, stand next to him. 7'3". Christopher Love tells the truth. Jerry Lawler, get out of here.
Honey, one more honey.
Well, there's no doubt about that. Damn I'm it. Over 6 feet tall, and he towers above me. Oh, my goodness.
I think he's a good
honey.
7'3".
Oh, boy. The Dragon Master with Christopher Honey.
All right, so we just have our main event left. I cut two matches. Had to be done. I'm going to have to edit this show before I put it up on YouTube, I think. Now, I was in Stamford, Connecticut recently. We all know I was on Karamo. I wasn't on the show, but I was in the audience. And also, while I was there, I auditioned for WWE's The Bump. They just fired their lead bumper, Matt Camp. And hey, we've joked about this before, Scott Twist. And now, here is my bump audition.
We can be the best ever did.
What's up, guys? We are on the road to WrestleMania, and the WWE Universe is buzzing about this episode of The Bump. I am your host this afternoon, Scott Twist. Kayla is unfortunately in Los Angeles, but don't you worry, WWE Universe, we have a packed show in studio today. We have Katana Chance. I cannot believe it. And also in studio, we have Ivar. The Viking Raider himself will be here to play a brand new game, Superstar or Candy, presented by Snickers. This is gonna be great.
Better them than me. They got a lot going on over there in Stamford, Connecticut. I'm so glad, out of all shows, that I'm across the country and Los Angeles, so I don't have to be
but
there.
But before any of that, we have a guest on the line, one of my favorite WWE superstars and the WWE World Heavyweight Champion, Seth freaking Rollins, will be here. I gotta tell you, this is a dream. To be here, to host The Bump is truly a dream.
This is about to be a dream show because that's a perfect time to bring him on right now. Please welcome our World Heavyweight Champion, Seth freaking Rollins.
Yeah.
What's up?
Hello, it took you guys long enough.
I apologize for the tech issues. Seth freaking Rollins, thank you so much for joining us on The Bump.
But I'm here, we're talking. What do you guys want to,
yes.
What do you want to get into?
Oh, what do I would like to talk about your wonderful career as a WWE superstar and everything that you do and how popular you are now. But also, people ask where I came from, and it's so crazy that I'm here. I host a live weekly wrestling mixtape on Twitch.
Man, I don't know.
And now
I'm here, and I
can't believe it.
How this happened.
It's so great.
This was in no way planned, no way. You know, they call me the visionary. They call me the architect. I see things. I build things. This is one of those. I got no clue where it came from. I got no clue where any of it came from, to be honest with you.
I'm just wondering if you have any advice, Seth freaking Rollins, about my career and what I should do to get into the WWE.
Burn it down.
Burn it down. Yes.
I'll see you guys next time.
Seth, thank you. We'll see you next time. Thank you. Ah, what a guy. What a guy. Well, that's the way
okay.
You kick off a show.
Okay, well, it didn't go quite as I expected. Everyone was kind of mean to me. But, look, I've been out of work all year. I lost my job at the end of the year, and I need money. So, anytime you want me, I'm ready. I'm ready to join the team. I'm ready to ditch the glasses. And the attitude, and I will be Scott Twist. Just give me a call. Give me a call. That's all.
After finishing the NDA this week, it's been good bipartisan cooperation and a string of.
And starting this moment from now, from this moment on, this will be the moment, starting now, of the genesis of McGillicuddy.
Can we hear from the winner now, please?
Hit the buzzer.
Let's hear it one more time from Michael McGillicuddy.
In the future, everything will be simple. With just a look and a thought, anything can be yours. Looking further. Deeper. Longer. Into the buzz.
Alright! Thanks for the subscriptions. Suzanne will gift and subs. Thank you so much.
Not just pro wrestling, but specifically Lucha Libre for many,
wow,
many years
Zowie.
Now. And a big
honey.
Opponent
honey.
Has been Gringo Loco, who has came up in this area 20-year veteran.
This is their main event. It is also straight out the buzz bin. ATL Blood Feast sent this one in as well.
You're right about that. And a man who's certainly no stranger to a promotion that you work for as well, MLW, getting gold all over the globe.
We watched Gringo versus John Moxley on the Buzz Bowl. That's on YouTube if you weren't there live. That show is in full. Penta! It's the Buzz Bin, honey!
A man who's won, I believe, 10 different sets of major World Tag Team Championships, not to mention a World Singles title in Impact Wrestling. Penta El Cerro Miedo has transisted beyond just Lucha Libre, become a cross-platform mainstream star.
Sometimes when the FMW siren ends, I still hear it in my head.
He was doing Cerro Miedo on the field to celebrate. He's amazing. A big wrestling fan. What a weekend it could be for them both.
Yeah, Penta versus Mike Santana at House of Glory next month. I'll be there. Mustafa Ali. He's on a run. He is on an independent run. Yeah, man, he's been trying to do this. He tried to leave WWE like twice.
The ovation is deafening. A man who started right here in the Chicago area, right here at Dreamwave, and became a worldwide superstar, but never forgot his roots or where he came from.
Ali rules, man. I'm so glad he's doing his thing.
To be the president of pro wrestling, we all want and need. And he's going town to town, listening to his great fans. Imagine that, someone wrestling, listening to the fans. Ali's doing it.
Well, he wasted no time to come back and give to the fans.
House of Glory is also debuting in Boston in a couple months, I think in May. I don't know if I'll be there. I'm waiting for Mr. Bookerman to tell me if I'll be there.
Grassroots movement, back to rediscovering that passion. What got him on the journey to begin with? Could it lead to a pivotal championship win?
Wow. The alternative champion. Makes me feel like I'm in a music store. Who's the alternative champion? Evan Dando? Steven Malkmus? Alternative champion is 120 minute time limit. Thanks. Wowie, I like that.
Several milestones in his career. And yes, he's the Dreamwave Alternative Champion. But not only that, he's reached 26 months holding the top championship at AAA. That mega title. He won the scramble. Likes of Jay Lethal and Bobby Fish and Samurai Del Sol, Bandito. He's beaten men like John Hennigan and Speedball Mike Bailey and Jack Cartwheel and Swerve Strickland, Ray Fenix. Some of the best anywhere. But Kingo has overcome, and it's been a similar road travel. As you see the prize being raised, alternative.
All right, this is your potluck main event. It is also the main event of this Dreamwave show.
You can tell the hometown favorite
Then again, maybe not so easy.
Everybody's getting a turn and getting chanted at.
Respect for all four of these men.
Oh, no. No. Resist the urge exactly. to chant all these guys. Just give everybody their little chant and then start the match. No, all these guys is necessary.
Well, here we go, ringing the bell for the main event.
Wait. Let me do my catchphrase. He's got to do it.
Oh. I'm assuming it's two words.
Nunchucks?
Maybe some colorful language thrown in.
No.
Oh.
Ali only making it one word.
Penta's body slams into Kingo. Strikes.
Oh, yeah. They're starting
as
off right.
Penta and Gringo in kind.
Oh, my God. Back and forth. These men are going to be unbelievable.
Super J Maskus Cup.
Mustafa Ali campaigning, but man, he just got derailed
on the God.
Campaign trail. Penta and Vikingo, the AAA connection, the AEW connection. Many say Vikingo is the next Ray Fenix. Maybe Penta takes offense, Fenix being Penta's brother.
Hey, no doubt about that. I've heard those comparisons. I've heard so many more. I've heard Rey Mysterio. What about Vikingo? What about if Vikingo wants to be the first Vikingo?
Yeah.
I think he's that and a whole lot more.
Woo!
Mysterio Tope Suicida to the outside.
I'll tell you one person I'm not envious of. It's the referee having to call the action inside of the ring, making sure that he can keep his eye on all four of these men.
I believe Vikingo's only 26 years old, 5'7", 175.
Unbelievable.
But takes so much pride in being a champion. From LaSalle to Mexico City and everywhere in between.
Great guy, too. Saw him taking pictures with people down before the show even started. I'm not even talking about in some sort of meet and greet situation. Just some fans who recognized him, man. This guy is starting to be an international superstar.
The smile Vikingo wears on his face more often than not tells the story of how much he loves this sport, what this means
yeah.
to him, what the fan support means to him.
He is Hijo del Vikingo, so the technically he would be the second Vikingo.
Two hometown heroes
wow.
and a Lucha legend in the making.
How do you counteract that? Unbelievable.
Spinning Tijeras by Vikingo, and Penta takes out the leg of Vikingo, and that could be a major game changer when it comes to Vikingo's gravity-defying offense.
Well, this title, not just a main eventing this show, but it goes to show the amount of talent inside of the ring, how important this is.
Vikingo will be quicker, carrying less body weight, great height of the crossbody.
Yeah. God, how does he even do that?
Spinning heel kick. I don't know if Vikingo's human.
That's a video game.
These two work so well together, Vikingo and Gringo Loco.
Vikingo in United States as well as Mexico.
Because Loco, the best base on planet Earth.
And keep in mind, before
although I think Black Taurus is a pretty damn good base.
Gringo Loco.
Yeah, but Gringo Loco might not be able to do a whole lot after this.
Could Vikingo be looking 630 splash? No, wrong splash. At great height. Is it enough?
Stops it with a senton.
I think it would have been enough if Ali had not interrupted that pinfall attempt there. Penta on the outside. Ali, you're right about that. After traveling around the world internationally, a WWE superstar, finally back here where it all began for him. Hometown boy, Dreamway.
Amongst his people, campaigning for the sport he loves, looking to bring change. That'll make everybody happy. Ali creates distance. In with the neck breaker.
Oh, the sell.
High and hard.
Yeah, you're right about that. Damaging on the back of the neck.
Gringo now looking to take control. Ali swings off the tornado DDT.
Gorgeous. Now Penta's inside of the ring.
Yeah, Penta. Ali never saw him coming until the kick hit the face.
Smart on Penta's part. Stay on the outside. Don't get in there until you
Penta's
have to.
So great. So he knows how to not do a lot.
Be doing exactly.
And
what
I mean that in the best way.
I think I might showboat at the bar a little bit later on.
Penta loves to get inside his opponent's heads, play those mind games. Ali, though, trying to counter.
Oh,
God!
And
but
wow.
Sometimes the high risk doesn't pay off.
Penta saw it coming.
To answer your question, I would try to do that and absolutely have no idea how. Unbelievable.
Oh,
wait a minute.
Stop. Pause.
Oh, we've seen this before. Hook shot to the ref.
Better than Abrahantis does it.
Man, I wanted a Penta singles run in AEW.
There's a sling blade by Penta. Two of the largest men I could name that wrestle that Lucha Libre rapid fire style.
Talking about the mind games, we just saw it there, how effective it was. Oh my God.
Penta used the momentum of Vikingo's offense to snap on the DDT, and Vikingo could have lost his own title that way, but interrupts the fall.
Reminder, this is not elimination style. This match could end any second. The champion does not even have to be pinned in order to lose.
Excellent call. Oh, Vikingo went for a crossbody, and Penta low bridges him. That's the danger of a matchup like this. Vikingo not even in the ring. If a fall happens, he's lost his title.
You're right about that, and we have three veterans in there right now. Oh my
God! Nice German by Ali.
That was amazing.
Ali's got deceptive power. Do not let his speed fool you. He's incredibly well put together.
Well, he apparently could do no wrong.
Beautiful.
Well, maybe he did there.
Are you kidding me?
Ali is the only person in this match who doesn't get checks from Tony Khan. Yet.
Into the standing moonsault. Is that enough? Oh. But again, you go for these covers early, and you're a sitting duck for Penta to interrupt.
At the same time, though, you're only...
Yeah, I wasn't watching Impact. Well, I mean, I've never, like, consistently watched Impact. Like, I always poke my head in and check
it out. It can happen when you least expect it, but so too can Penta.
Yeah, Gringo was working ROH.
I think Loco is right.
I don't know how regularly, but he was definitely working there a month
or
two ago.
Loco has been pursuing this alternative championship since he lost it. He loves nothing more than representing not just Lucha Libre, but all alternative styles of wrestling here in Chicago.
And we love watching him, but I'm not sure if he's going to love this. What the hell is going on that top rope?
Gringo has no idea what's coming. Gringo and Vikingo square off.
Oh, my God.
Vikingo, oh, my God.
What is this?
Vikingo is on Gringo's
This is better than any Tower of Doom.
For God's
what
sake.
The hell?
Oh, my God.
Double Spanish fly.
The enormity of the impact not lost on the Dreamway faithful here in LaSalle.
That was crazy.
Vikingo not just defying gravity, he's straight up disrespecting it.
Absolutely.
There's so much stuff in modern Lucha where I'm like, how did they even, like, think of that?
Mega champion of AAA. That's what?
Oh,
he's
my
the
Lord.
Champion.
God. Ate that turnbuckle.
I'm telling you, I have not seen that move perform that way only in a video game. I mean that. That was unbelievable. God.
The velocity and the ferocity.
Yeah, everybody gets on the top rope and looks up at the ceiling like, can I? And then they get scared. Ooh.
Springboard moonsault.
That's still not going to be it, though. Look at this.
Penta stepped up on that pin attempt.
Loco looks like he's still up.
Yeah, well, Penta did it off the back of Loco. That rocked him.
Well, Penta now looks like he might be trying to put Ali away here, but no, Vikingo.
Vikingo sense of urgency, knows his title's in jeopardy everywhere he turns.
Oh, fighting in the hardest and most dangerous part of the ring outside here.
Oh my God, that's a big...
I'm glad the Dreamwave title is on the line and not the Triple A, because now I really don't know who will win. Vikingo could lose this Dreamwave title, the alternative title.
The hardest part of the
ring. Oh my God!
It's true, damn it, Vikingo's hurt.
Sunset flip.
Mustafa Ali, 450.
That's got to be
specialty.
New champ,
Ali comes home.
Whoa!
Oh my God!
Just like that, new champion. Wow. That was a relatively short main event. Everybody's moving fast. Ali got that belt while the getting was good.
Mustafa Ali has endured so many struggles over the past few years of his career, from wanting his freedom, from the corporate lifestyle, from being held off television, from being put in disadvantageous situations.
Yeah, I like
but
that, man.
We see for sure.
You know, especially on tonight's episode of Potluck, we needed a fast main event. We couldn't do no 30-minute thing.
Ali's campaign on pro wrestling.
Someone who might not
look at Vikingo. What a nice guy.
But no, he's putting the title on Ali.
What a great dude.
Vikingo, high-profile match to probably anyone else in this country. Vikingo's a prideful man. Come out there and best him.
That was it. That's our show. What a show. We did it. We did a good one. Thank you, everybody. Three streams in a week. First time, last time. Yeah, this will be up on YouTube. I'll edit out all that nonsense where I'm like, what? What's going on? Huh? That will all be gone. It will look so seamless to the YouTube viewer. They'll have no idea. And if you're watching on YouTube, follow me on Twitch. And if you're watching me on Twitch, why don't you follow me on YouTube? That's where the old episodes live. That's where the salute to New Orleans will go up, the Buzz Bowl, all these things. Thank you, honey. thanks, everybody. I appreciate it. I really appreciate the calls. It was a grand caller festival. It was awesome. So many calls. And it makes me want to do more call-in type things. I like maybe something with, where people can tell stories of things, because we've done something like that before. And the chat was tremendous, as always. I think I'm going to stick with Soul Bully as the title of this one, but who knows. So that's that. Thank you, everybody. I've been Scotland Green, and this has been the Pro Wrestling Potluck. Oh!